Hey everybody, welcome back to Outdoor Inspirations. My name is Blake and today we are on site for a new project and I just wanted to show you kind of how everything goes with the wiring process when we do these installations. So how we overcome some of the obstacles that we'll see in the landscape, whether it be concrete, whether it be really big roots from some huge trees. So I got Skeets here with me and we're gonna run through that. So here we go.
So one tip that I like to always give everyone when they're doing their trenching is always move the mulch first to uncover any kind of lines that might be under here, irrigation. And what it also does is whenever you trench and if you have mulch, it compresses. You can't get into the dirt. But here, as you can see, I can go in. But if I had this, I can't go in. So you gotta break the surface. You gotta first move your mulch and then make your trench with your trencher. So here what we like to do is first run our lines very close to the foundation here. As you can see, we're right against the foundation. And we, of course, we stake this down, sod stakes. And at each lighting fixture, we have our whip to our fixture and we put a loop. And this loop is for our connection. And also if the light fixture needs to move at all, we have slack in our line here to make any kind of adjustments. I can go here, I can go there, I can go anywhere. We like to go close to the foundation primarily because it keeps our lights out of harm's way, out of lines out of harm's way. And as you can see, it makes a nice clean install. I mean, you just go all the way along the line or around the foundation, you put your dirt back and then your mulch back. And it's good to go. No one ever bothers it because it's right at the foundation.
And to reiterate, the main reason that we are putting it so close to the foundation is because it's the safest way to protect the wire. So that way, if we're up against the house foundation, when actually this house right now, they're getting landscaping done.
Yeah, cover's fine.
So when they come in and do all this landscaping, since we don't have our wires running straight through the middle of the bed, they're not going to hit our wires. And so that's one of the things that you want to look for, because if you go ahead and do wiring straight through the middle of a bed, at some point there is going to be landscaping done and those wires are going to get cut because that company doesn't know that there's wires there, or they don't know where your wires went. And so that's a major thing, is making sure that you take the extra steps that your wire is going to be safe. So obviously the main part of laying wire down is we have to cut a little trench into the soil or into the grass or beds or wherever. And so what we do is we use this trenching shovel.
Ta-da!
And so, so we go a minimum of 6 inches down and just basically create a little split into the soil. And then it allows us to push that wire down. Actually, the wire's in there now and you can barely tell.
Hey, look, I'll pull it out for you just so you can see how deep it is. See that wire? Look how far I can put that down in there. That's all the way down in there.
And so putting it that deep allows us to not have to worry about if the erosion is gonna pull the wires up, whether it be from animals, whether it be from someone planting something in the garden. Obviously, if someone comes in with a shovel and goes right down in where the wire is, the wire isn't indestructible. But there are places where we will use conduit. And so we use a flexible conduit that in certain areas we'll use just to protect it a little bit more. All right, so one of the things that we see a lot is there's a driveway that's separating two parts of the yard where we need some lighting to go. And so we have to go across the driveway. Sometimes there's a drainage pipe that we can go under the driveway so we don't have to do any digging or grinding or anything like that. But in this specific circumstance, we did have to go through one of the cracks in the driveway. So you can see here, there's a nice substantial crack going straight across where we need to, over here where Fernando's at. And what we did, Skeets, you wanna explain what we did?
Yeah, of course. So here, there's a little bit of dirt in here and whatnot for over the years, little buildup that gets in these cracks here. So all we did was take our grinder and made a nice little cut, dug it out with this tool right here, and ran our wire. Then we're gonna cover it back up with the same dirt that was previously there, and you'll never know it's there.
So going over top of the driveway allows us to get to other areas. And when it's covered back up, I can actually put a picture up for you. This is what it looks like. And it actually, I mean, you can't even tell that we were there. We caulk back over it. We take the shavings from anything that we grinded out and we'll sprinkle that kind of back on top. So it'll color match pretty well. And yeah, it's seamless and nice and easy. And Skeets loves doing it.
It's the best. So if you're doing garden edges like here on this bed, a lot of times a landscaper will come past and hit that with a garden edger to make a nice line on the mulch. So what we'll do here is we'll put a piece of conduit. So if they do come and cut pretty deep, we have a protection for our cable here so we don't get cut. Usually it's a bright white. Sometimes I'll even put a little bit of E-tape on it, colored E-tape, yellow, red, something, so that when they do hit it and they can see it, it'll be a nice bright and be like, oh, let me stop, so they don't cut our landscape lighting line. There's a few other applications where we would like to use conduit. If we go underneath a sidewalk, what I like to do is put a piece of conduit, two elbows on it, and then cap it after we're done. And what that does is, in the future, if you ever need to run another wire, it's much easier than having to dig the whole thing back up and then restarting again.
And that's the one thing that we've found lately that some homeowners have been doing kind of for us. When we go to a lot of houses that have just been built, and they've already thought that out and they have conduit run for us already. And so it makes our job a lot easier, and it actually saves money because it's less time of Skeets having to go through the concrete and drill for an hour, however long it is. Running the wire is a very important part of a project, just because that is the backbone of the lighting. Like if your wire fails, so does your system. Some people think that it's just the fixtures themselves that are the most important part, but it's not necessarily true. So appreciate you guys for watching. This is just a little short little snippet just to kind of give you an idea of how our wiring is done, and give you some eyes on exactly how we do it. So thank you guys for watching. We look forward to seeing you in the next one. Peace out.